Hello students, today's lesson for geography is trade. What is the meaning of trade? Buying and selling of goods and services to fulfill each other's need is trade. Buying and selling of good is called visible trade. There are two types of trade, visible trade and invisible trade. What is a visible trade? Buying and selling of goods. And what is invisible trade? Buying and selling of services is called invisible trade. Trade is divided into two parts based on the quantity of goods, that is wholesale trade and retail trade. What is a wholesale trade? Buying from manufacturers in large quantities and selling to retailers in large lots are wholesale trade. And what is retail trade? Buying in small quantities from wholesaler and selling them in small quantities to consumer. Consumer means a person who is utilizing that goods. According to the extent of region, trade is divided into domestic trade and international trade. Refers to buying and selling within the geographical boundaries of one country is domestic trade or internal trade, that trade, the business we are doing within our nation, that buying, selling, purchasing, things are happening in between city to city, town to town, state to state. Buying and selling between two or more countries, that is international trade. We are selling our goods to some other country, that is called as international trade. Buying goods and services from other countries, that we are purchasing from the outside, that is other countries like China, Japan, that is called as import trade. Selling goods and services to other countries, that our products we are selling to America or Japan, that is called as export trade. The difference between the import and export values of country in a specific period is balance of trade. What is a balance of trade? It is divided in once again into three parts, that is unfavorable balance of trade, favorable balance trade and balanced balance of trade. Now what is unfavorable balance of trade? When the value of imports is more than the value of export, that whatever we are giving, we are selling to the foreign countries, our selling is less and purchasing from the foreign countries become more. What is favorable balance of trade? When the value of export is more than the value of imports, that our export value is more, that we are selling our products to the foreign countries in abundant more and income is coming more, that is a favorable balance of trade. Now what is a balanced trade? When value of export almost equal to the value of import, both the import and export, they are the trade is same, then it is called as balanced trade. The organizations which work towards the growth and development of international trades are international trade organization. They are looking after the global market, global trade. Now some economic organization of the world is WTO, that is World Trade Organization, consists of 164 member states to provide a platform to negotiation in international trade. WTO was formed to handle the differences related to international trade. Then EU, that is European Union, includes 28 European countries formed to establish an integrated market. EU was formed in order to assure free flow of goods and services within member nations of Europe. OPEC, that is Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, has 13 member states. It was formed to control the international trade of crude oil. SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, has 8 members. It was formed to find satisfactory solution to the common problems faced by countries in South Asia. Then ASEAN, that is ASEAN, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, has 10 state members. It was formed to promote regional peace and economic growth among the Southeast Asian countries. APEC, that is APEC, Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, has 21 member states. It was formed to promote free trade and economic cooperation in Asia Pacific Ocean region. BRICS, that is BRICS, that is Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, was formed to make funds available for the growth of economics of members and strengthening economic security. The commercial functions involve when an invisible flow develops when a product goes from producer to consumer, that is called as marketing. The major components of marketing are price of commodity, sales promotion, advertising, distribution. So these all were the important contents, important points I explained you related with the trade, that is internal as well as external. So hope you have understood, and further once again I will be explaining in you in the Zoom class. Thank you.